Sydney never seems able to rest in peace, our past constantly being buried by progress. A photo exhibition of a vast cemetery that once occupied land near Central Station opens at the State Library tomorrow. The headstones depicted telling priceless stories.
Tens of thousands of commuters each day walk Central Station's Devonshire Street underpass through what was once a cemetery.
Devonshire Street Cemetery was consecrated in 1820. Prior to that, it was essentially sandhills. That Surrey Hills area was one great big sandhill. People who lived in Sydney were buried then for the next 40 or so years, up until the mid-1860s.
But the city would quickly envelop the increasingly crowded, hallowed ground.
There were concerns about bad smells emanating from the place. There was concern about overcrowding.
And so it would lay as still as those that it cradled, slowly overgrowing with abandonment, until Central Station began construction in 1901. The 30,000 souls buried there ordered to move on.
It is very much higgledy-piggledy.
It is. You can see the difference in the headstones. You can see monuments. And here you can actually see a visitor to the cemetery. We don't know who she is.
And we may well wouldn't have known about the cemetery, except for husband and wife team Josephine and Arthur Foster.
They basically just spent their days off, their weekends, their public holidays in the cemetery, documenting some of the headstones.
As Josephine would take photos of the headstones, Arthur would run ink through the carved copper plate to better see each epitaph.
The tombstones document the unusual ways people met their demise in the mid-1800s in Sydney.
That's right. I mean, pretty brutal. Transport accidents, obviously very common.
As was, it seems, death by servant, or lunatic, or log, or drowning in a puddle in Hunter Street.
She was a mother of three children. She was drunk and she just passed out and died there. This is Richard Murray, who was actually a cricketer for New South Wales. But you can see the beautiful stonework of the cricket bats and the wicket and the cricket ball.
From first fleeters to first brewer, from decamp to Bligh to Indigenous identity, the Devonshire Street Cemetery would be a temporary rest and more likely lost in time, if not for Josephine and Arthur Foster.
We want to really pay homage to their work because it was just out of their passion and their interest that we have this amazing collection today. It's incredibly significant and fascinating and really provides us with an insight into the daily lives and deaths of Sydneysiders.
Mike Dalton, Nine News.